Welcome back to another edition of Audio Fiends. So we're continuing on the Dirk album. We are on track 8. So we got sad songs. Berlin's song was called Sex Songs. So he's got sad songs.
I'm telling somebody.
I like comparing those two.
Please don't. One who's nice, one who's not. One who has skill, one who doesn't.
Let me know in the chat who you think is better, Tory Lanez or Lil Durk. I bet we get a lot of Durk people.
Doesn't mean anything.
I would give it to Tory Lanez, but I bet we get a lot of people that say.
You think it's close?
I think they have a similar skill set when it comes to making music.
Yeah, but you think it's close?
Close? No.
That's why I mean, when you say similar skills, it's just like they can rap and sing.
It's more than that. The way they, I think, they're like, they have this chameleon like ability. They both have that. They're both very good with their ad libs. They're both very good with the singing. Yeah.
Okay.
They're quite similar. Not in terms of style, but in terms of their skill set.
Okay.
Anyway, don't forget to like. Don't forget to subscribe. Get into this, man. Oh, this nigga's nice.
Okay, don't text her right now.
For somebody else on his beat?
Text her right now. This song ain't
what no you doing in the background?
Pretty little thing, you just a pretty little light you got on. Pretty little thing, make me break the couple thousand. Appreciate the look.
Who's the producer? Hold up. We got Touch of Trent and Haze. Click on him. Who the producer? This is going crazy. This guy's made a bunch of Dirk songs. Voice of the Heroes, Computer Murders, No Interviews, India Part 3, Evil Twins. Alright, that's Touch of Trent. Haze, he's got In a Minute, Little Baby, I Can't Take It Back, Young Boy, 40 Side with Nas. He was also on Voice of the Heroes.
Nigga make music with all the trash niggas.
Wow, just
you know, it's because it's just
idiotic
like,
shit. It's just idiotic.
It's just like you look at you listen to Travis Scott's song. You say, "Who are the producers?" Mike Dean, T, Wonder Girl. You see niggas that are actually nice,
bro.
But then you look at and you see the tracks that they produce on. You go, "Damn!" And you see these niggas just a bunch of no name songs with a bunch of mid-ass niggas that just flood the industry with music. The Polo G's, the Lil Durks, the Lil Baby. Come on, bro. Sags.
His opinions do not reflect the opinions of this podcast. That's crazy.
That's facts.
Yeah, let's keep going.
Thing you came from public house, 18 million for one song. I'm so home when you announce. I like high end restaurants when I read the menu, I can't pronounce. I went toxic for 2 months. I showed the streets I don't need cancer. Ever since we had got sex, she don't ever want to wear pants. She likes shopping on Farfetch, get me watching out for her page. I was hard for so long.
There's another thing that he can do, like Tory Lanez, like he understands how to use his voice as an instrument. Especially with the ad-libs within the music, you know, you can tell he knows how to sing. He knows how to sing properly. He knows how to ride the wave of the beat and the melody.
Here's a problem. His voice is like a saxophone that's got a dent in it.
You're an idiot!
It's got a dent in it.
You're an idiot!
Because, like, this is what I'm saying, right? Yeah, sure, you can follow a tune, right? For the rest of my life, I'm always gonna reference this. In our DD Osama reaction, what that nigga was doing with his singing, I can't believe it. To this day, I'm shocked. I can't believe he did that and he thought, yeah, this is good.
Go watch the DD Osama video.
So, yeah, sure, he knows how to follow a tune a little bit, but the singing's not particularly good.
It's
in any
pretty
type of
good
way.
Singing.
And one thing, you have to stop saying this to me. A nigga going, yeah, 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 in the background, that's just so the music isn't garbage, bro! And then you got a little ad-lib, and this is ad-libs, just so that it's not boring. That's what that's doing. It's not
that's important.
Special.
A lot of niggas don't even do that.
And those niggas are trash. We don't talk about that.
Right now, you better relax, buddy. You better cool it.
I ain't gonna lie. I was listening to... I had a live stream up, and then it, like, refreshed. And the second the when it refreshed, the person who was on the live stream was like, "Shut the fuck up, stop talking." I was like, "Damn, somebody talking to me?"
Bro, they was putting facts though. Like, yo, you do need to shut up, bro. You saying some stupid shit.
Alright, you wanna continue?
Yeah, let's continue. She gave you my drive. Had a model kissing on the street, bitch, but I'ma keep between my family. I'm coming, she keep on sucking. I told her, stop, she grab my diamond. I know how it feels to be lied on. This ain't gangsta shit on my headphones, it's a sales home. I gave in to you on a text message, it's red wrong. He talking to one of the most famous girls off my man's phone. Bro, he knows how to hit the auto tone. He's making difference. I'm sorry, told you the stories, and you ain't explaining it now. Hey, that's good. I said I'm sorry. I hate you think that I'm tough. I don't know what you do to me. Better think about your life insurance before you tell your friend that you threw with me. Told her shit that could ruin me. Cut her off, she stopped texting me back. That shit was blowing me. I could really have it my way if I wanted to. I'm a walking horse. You didn't like that part?
I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. I didn't care about it. It wasn't bad. It just didn't move me. Yo, Chanel Pico, fresh off the runway, she Georgie. Let her be so she running my mind all this morning. Authorized you on my bank account, she stuck regardless. Used to say Amari for Mary Jane, cause we ain't had nothing. Used to say Amari for Mary Jane, that shit retarded. PTSD, I got cheated on, baby, I'm poly. It is what it is, think what you want, whatever you call it. I done seen real tears, had a miscarriage, blood in the toilet.
Bro, this nigga's nice. I said I'm sorry. I hate you think that I'm tough. You listen to this? Yeah, I'm putting this shit on my playlist. See, bro, this might be the best song yet.
This nigga giving a nigga plays for out of spite.
Huh?
Out of spite for me.
I have no reason to hate. I have no reason to glaze, like, I'm just listening to music.
Out of spite for me.
You're the one that's spiteful.
Why would I be spiteful?
You're refusing to go into the music with an open mind.
Why are you saying that?
It's evident. It's true. You start hating immediately before the song even plays. Go into the next song with an open mind. But for this song, what do you rate it?
Like a 5.5?
This song's like a 7. This is really
good. How do you want me to listen to a song with a beat like this?
It's just dumb.
Like, it's a part of the song, so am I supposed to tune that out?
What was wrong with the beat?
That shit was trash. More pain beats, more trash.
You gotta get away from this, man.
It's garbage.
You gotta get away from this.
It's unlistenable. It's close to country music.
Bro, what are you talking about?
It's close to country music.
You're saying anything.
It's fine, bro.
It's fine. It's fine. We're gonna get him eventually. You can't hate for so long. Eventually, you're gonna see some movement in the body.
I can't believe. I move sometimes. I'm trying. You can see me rocking back and forth a little. This shit is trash, bro. I can't listen to it.
Alright, it's fine. Don't forget to like. Don't forget to subscribe. We're gonna catch you in the next video. Peace out.